Okay, fine. Omar, Omar, please turn on your camera. Omar.
Yes, sir.
Please turn on your camera. Ah, yeah, Omar is here. Do you know me, Omar? An idea?
Yes, sir.
An idea, yeah. Tell me, what is my name? Ah, that's it. You forgive for that. Fantastic. Thank you very much. Okay, it is not like a class 10, Mr. Okay. I know my name, no problem. Okay, Mr. Omar, you have to attend all the classes. That's the first request. Okay, it is not like class 10. Okay, class 11 it is. So the continuation is there for the next year for the board examination. So that seriousness is necessary. Okay, anyway, don't take it as a advice or something, just a suggestion. Okay, clear, Mr. Omar? Hope you will attend the class.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Vasudev? Okay, so let it be. So that's it. So you want to know Mr. Omar? Omar, please introduce yourself.
My name is Omar. I'm from class 11C. I'm coming from Charai.
Charai. Okay. So Vasudev, please introduce yourself one time.
My name is Vasudev. I'm coming from Kodimallur, class
11C. Class 11C. Okay. So you know your names there, but title card says your names there. That's good. Anyway, we'll start the first lesson from the textbook, the political theory. Political theory. Okay. So what is the name of the first chapter? Mr. Sanam Jose?
Sir, political theory and introduction.
Political theory and introduction. Okay. So one more student join in our class. No, it's Omar only. From another camera or another mobile?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Oh, okay, fine. So listen carefully. Listen carefully. So the first chapter, it is political theory and introduction. Political theory and introduction. So I would ask a question to you people. What do you know about political theory? Any idea about political theory? Okay, before asking political theory, I would like to ask a question. What is politics? Okay, politics you know. And what is political science? Can anyone tell me? Political science.
Study of politics?
Study politics, only politics? So you're studying about the political bodies or political activities? Not only that. Anything else? Any idea?
The government.
Government, okay, fine, good. The administration and the government, then Sandra, constitution.
So is it like to understand a system that goes on the country?
Definitely. The system that existing in the country, fine. So we are all the part of that system, right or not? Of course, very good. Okay, anything else? Any other ideas? Okay, so to lead a good life in this society, there are numerous things we are required. We need number of things we need to lead a good life in the society. Okay. Can anyone tell me what are those things? Material things are there. Non-material things also are there to lead a good life in the society. So tell me what are they. So first of all, we will discuss about the material things that we need to lead a good life in the society. Amal Roshan, tell me what are things you need to lead a good life in the society. Tell me first.
Money.
Yeah, money. So that was the first thing, right? Okay, money. Then?
Food.
Food. Yeah, very good. Then?
Shelter.
Shelter, good. Yeah, housing. Then? Shelter, that answer given by Mr. Abhilash, right? Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Then? Anything else, Amal? Basic necessities, right? Basic necessities. Food, shelter, clothing. Food, shelter, clothing. We know that. Those are the basic necessities. And Amal Ocean told that the most important thing, that is money, right? Amal, money. Okay, fine. So that is important for us. Material things. Okay. So number of luxurious products also are there that give us more comfort. Clear? Number of things are there. We are able to purchase that with money. That with the money. So related with this, okay, we know that we have to spend money to occupy these products there. Okay, the same time, there are numerous non-material things also are there in the life. Okay, if you want to lead a good life in the society, There are number of non-material things are there. Do you know what are they? What are they? Any idea?
Rules and regulations.
Rules and regulations. Okay. Rights. That's controlling the system. Okay, fine. Then?
Rights.
Rights. Very good. Rights. We want rights. Human rights. Fundamental rights. Then?
Equality.
Equality, very good answer. Equality, we need equality. Okay, the rules should treat everyone as equal. There is no special provisions for anyone. There is no privileges for anyone. Clear or not? All want to lead an equal life or equal, want to enjoy equal, what do you can say? Rights in the society. We can say like that too, equal rights. Equality, an egalitarian society. Egalitarian society where equality exists. Then, anything else? Rights, equality.
Benefits.
Pardon?
Benefits.
Benefits, okay. So benefits in a sense, what type of benefits? You want to receive something from the government or want to receive from the other people from the society?
Government. Anything.
Government, okay. So yeah. It is the responsibility of the government to provide or create a welfare society. Fine, then, anything else?
Safety.
So I took two major points from that. One is rights, other is equality. Come on. What about freedom, liberty? Freedom and liberty. Right, we want freedom, right, liberty, of course. So we are unable to lead a good life in a society where there is no freedom. There is no freedom. You have money, but the government says don't want to purchase anything from the shops. There is no freedom. Money is there, but there is no freedom. Okay. The government says to you, sorry, insisting you people to eat only the vegetarian food. So money is there with you, but you are unable to eat the food that you like. Clear? There is no freedom. There is no freedom. So just understand these points with you. Okay, what is that? The basic some things are there, non-material things are there, that is very important to lead a good life into society, like equality, freedom, and liberty, right? Yeah, that's what, freedom only the liberty, equality, liberty, and what? Rights discussed. What about justice? Justice? Justice means, what is that?
Giving people what they deserve.
Yeah, of course. Then equally, should not allow anybody to enjoy something more in number or more in quantities. Clear?
Yes.
Okay, that's what justice. Equally want to treat everyone by the viewpoint of law. Okay, justice. Clear? So these are called to be the very important aspects to lead a good life in the society. Clear? We want freedom, we want to enjoy the rights. Clear? We want equality and we want justice. We want the justice. So these words or these things are the important part of the political theory. Political theory. Clear? The political ideology. We want to study about these things in this textbook. The importance of freedom, the importance of justice, importance of equality, clear? Or importance of what you can say, rights. Clear or not? Okay, so that's what we are discussing in this textbook throughout this year. Clear? Then the first chapter is only an introduction to that. Okay, what all these things are, what is the importance of these things in our life. Okay, so we will start with our constitution, the preamble of the Indian constitution. Clear? Can anyone tell me what the preamble of the Indian constitution, the preface of the Indian constitution, preface of the Indian constitution? For any book we are able to find a preface that says about that book, what contained in that book, right? So for the Indian constitution also a preface is there, that is termed as the preamble of the Indian constitution. Okay, the preamble of the Indian constitution. What preamble? Okay, so the preamble starts like, we the people of India, right? Yes or no? So observe it clearly. We, the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign democratic republic. What kind of country is India? The sentence states that. It's a sovereign country. What do you mean by the term sovereignty or sovereign? What is meaning of the term sovereign?
Self-rule.
Right. Independent.
Independent. Any other meanings are there?
Self-rule.
Oh, definitely. Okay. We have our own government. And our government is functioning in the country. Okay, functioning in the country with all powers, all powers. It is not the puppet of any other country. There is no foreign directions. There is no foreign control. Okay, our country have our own government and it is ruling the country. Clear? It's a democratic one. Democratic one means? What do you mean by democratic one? Huh? What kind of government is a democratic government?
Elections, holding elections.
Our own government, people's rule, right? The representative rule, clear or not? And in such kind of government, the power is not concentrated in the hands of any single individual or groups of individuals. Clear? It is decentralized. Power is decentralized. Okay, how the power is decentralized in a democracy? It is decentralized. Tell me, Abhilash.
By separating it into different
organs of the government. Clear?
Yeah.
Yes. What are the organs of the government?
The executive,
legislature. Very good, Sandra and Abhilash. Legislature, executive, and judiciary. Legislature, executive, and judiciary are the three organs of the government. So, in a democratic setup, the power of the government is distributed to legislature, executive, and judiciary. So there is no centralization of power. It is decentralized. Okay. Next one. Republic. What do you mean, republic? Republic. There is a constitution, and it was, or it is protected by the head of the state. Head of the state. We are celebrating Republic Day in India, right? Right, Omar? Are we?
Yes, sir.
Yes. The 26th day of?
January.
January. Okay. That's what? A republic. Okay. What is that? A constitution, a written or unwritten. Okay. And it is safeguard, protected by the head of the state. Head of the state is there. Who's the head of the states? An idea?
Governor.
Governor. Your state president. Means the country, Amal.
Minister.
President.
The president. Okay, the president. Okay, for the country I am asking. State means, Amal Roshan, let me say that. State means not that state. Here state means a country. Okay, Amal? State means a country. That's the meaning here. Okay, so come back. Give me a moment, please. Okay, you can see here, right? Okay, we the people of India have a solemn resolve to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic, and it is secure to all its citizens. Okay, so it's a responsibility of the constitution to protect and secure all its citizens. What the constitution is securing here? Providing justice. Okay, we can see the words here. What kind of justice? Social justice, economic justice, and political. Okay, what are they? Justice. What kind of justice it is? Social justice, economic justice, and political justice. Clear? Okay, next one it is liberty. Liberty. So observe all these words we discussed already. Liberty. What kind of liberty? Liberty of thought. You can think anything, no problem. And you can express. Okay, so liberty of thought, expression. You can express your thoughts, express your ideas. You are free to do that. Okay, you are free to believe. Okay, what kind of liberty? Liberty of thought, expression, and belief. Belief in the sense you can believe in any religion. Clear? You have the right to not to believe also. Clear? Okay, you are a free to believe in any religion, the same time not to believe. Faith and worship, that also related with the religion. Clear or not? Faith and worship. Any worship methods you can choose, you are free to do that. Equality, okay, equality of status and of opportunity. Clear? Everyone, all are equal before the law. There is no special provision for anyone. There is no special privileges for anyone. All have equal opportunity. Equal opportunity. Clear? You know the examinations are equal for everyone. The same question paper for each and everyone, right or not? Okay. Huh? Yes. Opportunity. Equal opportunity for everyone. And to promote them all, fraternity. What the next word? Fraternity. What do you mean by the term fraternity?
Fraternity.
Pardon? Amal. One more time.
Dignity among all.
Dignity, we already discussed that. Assuring the dignity of the individual. Okay, so fraternity in the sense, not the dignity basically. It is brotherhood. Clear or not? Brotherhood. So everyone want to treat the other individual as our brother or sister. The brotherhood. Assuring the dignity of the individual. So it is protecting the dignity. Fraternity always protecting the dignity. If a friendship is there, a good relationship between individuals, always the one person will protect the dignity of the other, right? Okay. And it will helpful for the integrity of the nation. What do you mean integrity? Unity of the nation, right? Okay. So in our Constituent Assembly, this 26th day of November 1949, so 26th day of November 1949, do hereby adopt, enact, and give to ourselves this constitution. Clear? That's what the things that about the preamble of the Indian constitution. So almost all this philosophical viewpoint, the constitution makers, they discussed about that and added all these things in the constitution. So in the constitution, we are able to find, okay, the things that related with the equality, okay, related with the justice, related with the rights, okay, fraternity. So all these things are included in the constitution. So you might observe that three words, equality, liberty, and fraternity. Liberty, equality, fraternity. So these three words are related with one revolution. Tell me which revolution is that?
French Revolution.
Very good. The French Revolution. French Revolution. Okay, liberty, equality, and fraternity. Okay, so you got the point. What is that? We adopted the principles or the major aspects or points that we need to lead a good life in the society, not only from India, from different countries. Clear or not? Before India's independence, number of countries already emerged. Democratic countries already emerged before India's independence. They made their own constitutions. Clear? And we adopted the good points from those constitutions and pasted that in the Indian constitution. Clear or not? Okay. So such kind of number of good values are included in the Indian constitution. Indian constitution. Clear? So now we are going to discuss about rights. So hope these ideas are clear for you people, right? So I told you there are two textbooks are there. One is the, what is the name of the first textbook?
Political theory.
The political theory, So theoretical aspects are there. Next one, the Indian Constitution at work. Okay, so the first textbook we are able to find the theoretical aspects. Okay, or philosophical viewpoint of politics. Okay, second book says about the Indian constitution and how it's functioning. Okay, various rules and regulations that existed are included in the Indian constitution. Clear? Okay, now I already told you that we are going to discuss about rights. Clear or not? Tell me, what are rights? And what is the importance of rights? Can anyone?
The basic necessity of an average citizen in India.
Like definitely.
What they can exercise.
So we want to lead a good life in the society. So rights are important. Rights are important. So tell me, how many fundamental rights are there?
Seven.
One more time.
Seven.
One more time.
Seven.
Is that correct? Six or seven?
Seven rights.
7? Then tell me what are they? The 7 aspects.
Right to equality.
Right to equality.
Right to freedom.
Right to freedom.
Right against exploitation.
Right against exploitation.
Then right to practice in your religion.
That is a part of freedom.
Freedom of religion, cultural and educational rights.
Rights, okay.
And then right to constitutional remedies.
Right to constitutional remedies. Now, how many are there?
And right to property also.
Right to property, it is deleted. Okay. Right to property is a civil right now. Clear? Right to property is a civil right. Because the right to property is a fundamental right. What is the problem? Everyone can go to the court and ask for property, right? So it's my fundamental right. Your Highness, Your Majesty. Okay. So it's my fundamental right. What is that? Right to property. So it is your responsibility, the responsibility of the government to provide land for us. Clear? So that is deleted. That is now the part of a civil right. Clear? It's not a fundamental right anymore. It is a civil right. Clear? Clear? Okay. So civil right in the sense, you have the right to get the property from our parents. Okay. I mean, ancestral property. We can use that. That's all right. No problem. Okay. So just understand that points there. Clear? So you know about all these things there. So tell me about, what about the right to education? What is that? Cultural and educational rights.
Every child up to 14 years or something should be educated compulsorily.
Definitely.
By the parents.
Yeah. Okay. Or it is the responsibility of the government, the state. Okay. So the kids up to the age of 14, not only the parents. Okay. Clear or not? The government also considering as the guardian. Clear? Okay. So it is the responsibility of the parents. Okay, at the same time, it's the responsibility of the government. So, government is unable to provide education for a kid below the age of 14. He can approach the court. Okay, and he or she can file a case against the government. Because that is a fundamental right. It is the responsibility of the government to provide. Clear? If it is not so, he can or she can approach the court. Mr. Kosi, the things are clear or not? Kosi means his father.
Yes,
sorry, man. Mr. Kevin. Okay. Mr. Kevin, okay, the things are clear, right? So I am calling Mr. Kosi. So his parents, father will come and attend the class, I think so. Okay, let it be. Okay, Mr. Kevin, sorry for that. Okay, so the things are clear, right? Okay, so please change your title card, man. Okay, Omar, the things are clear or not? Omar?
Yes, sir.
So Omar, I am again requesting you, okay, attend the classes properly. Mr. Sanam Jos?
Yes, sir.
Miss Sandra?
Yes, sir.
Are you able to understand my language, guys?
Yes,
Sandra,
sir.
And Abhilash?
Sir.
No problem, right? Okay, so tell me if any problem is existing or persisting, you can. Okay, so that's about the right to education is the responsibility of the government. Okay, so fine. So, sorry. It's called to be SSA, Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan. Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan. It's a program by the government to provide education for the kids below the age of 14. Okay. And a midday meal program. What is midday meal program? Midday meal program.
Lunch given by the government.
Free lunch. Asking about food, everyone has the answer with them. Right. Okay, fine. Okay, it's a midday meal program. Okay, so free lunch for the kids, those attending the school, right? Basically, government-controlled schools. The schools that are managed by the state or the government. Okay, so here state means the administrative unit of the country, state. Okay, fine. Clear? Okay, next one. Right to expression. Right to speech. What is that?
The right to express your opinions.
Definitely.
And speak out, yeah.
Fine, good. There is no government free from criticism. Clear? We have the right to criticize any government. Our thoughts, our criticism, our ideas, we are free to express that in a democratic country. So you might have heard about the freedom for media. Okay. What media freedom? What do you mean media freedom?
Right to information.
Right to question.
The fourth pillar of democracy. What? Medias. Fourth pillar of a democracy, medias. Okay. Legislative, executive, judiciary. Then one more is there. What is that? The medias. Okay. So, medias always, they are free to criticize anyone in the country. Okay. Anyone in the country means personal criticism is not accepted. Clear or not? They cannot show our image and say this person is so and so. Okay. This is not good. So, we also have the right to criticize the people, those who did it. Okay, so not like that. Okay, so related with the government, government programs and government policies, they are able to criticize. So we are free to express our ideas. We are expressed to speak, no problem. That doesn't mean that, okay, we are hiring big speakers and placing that in the corner, okay, and start speaking about your neighbor, scolding someone. Okay, it's not good. That's not good. That is not permittable. Okay, clear or not? It is offense too. Okay, so that's what we are free to do that. We are free to do that. Okay, clear? Next one. What is that? What are the other rights? Sorry. What are the other rights?
Exploitation.
Right against exploitation. Not rights. Right. Okay. Right against exploitation. What do you mean by that?
Can't force anyone to labor.
Pardon?
Can't force anyone to labor.
Definitely. We cannot force anyone to do something for us or in favor of us without any payment, mentally or physically. Clear or not? Okay. So, might you studied about the beggar system, the beggar one. What do you mean by beggar system? Vetti system that existed in the pre-colonial India and even in the colonial India too. Okay. Under the British rule also, that type of labor existed. Okay, what do you mean by that? An idea?
They used to force the villagers to work for them.
Definitely. Okay, they forced the villagers to work for them without any payments. Even the landlords of India also did the same. Okay, it's called to be beggar. It's a kind of exploitation. Without any payment, they were to render their physical labor. Okay, so that's again is the rule. Clear? So we will discuss a number of other things in the next class. Okay, so next class, I already told you that please download a copy of the first chapter. Okay, political theory and introduction. Okay, it is available in the NCERT set. Please do that. Okay, and we are able to overcome the problem of absence of a textbook. Clear? So hope you people are able to understand the things properly. Okay, and any doubts or any troubles or any clarification, if you need so, you can. So I forgot to say one thing. I started telling the phone number, right? What happened? A power failure, right? Okay, not completed that. I told only four numbers, I think so. Okay, it is 8281257673. 7673. Okay, so one more PDD is there today. One more session is there today. The last one up by 4:20, right? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yeah,
yes,
so we will meet at that time. Okay, guys, fine. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.